Welcome, welcome, my good friends of YouTube. My name is Maddie Jones, and today I'm very proud to announce a new series that will be done both on here and on Twitch. I have put a Division II school into NCAA Football 14. I have put the Division II UNC-Pembroke Braves into NCAA Football 14. First off, I want to thank the Florida man for making this all possible, putting the team together. This team has replaced Charlotte as Charlotte's program has suddenly decided to end. Also, by the way, I just want to point out that UNC-Pembroke actually beat Charlotte in 2013, so I think we all know what the better program is. This team's going to be a very fun dynasty and perhaps a very, very tough one. We're going to be running it on Heisman, Seagator sliders, coach progression slow, and we're starting at level 1. First things first, though, we got to go through some rules. The first rule is that 75% of our players in recruiting must come from the state of North Carolina and South Carolina. I did both because, well, Pembroke's very close to South Carolina, so North or South Carolina, 75% of our recruits must come from. The other rule, we'll be starting out as a 2-star prestige, which means that most of this team, to start off, will be 2 or 3-star, maybe even a little bit of 1-star. We absolutely need to get a position field. Once we get to a 3-star prestige, we will have the opportunity to get at least 1 4-star player. Once we get to a 4-star prestige, it'll be 2 4-stars or 1 5-star. 5-star prestige, 2 5-stars or 3 4-stars. And so on and so forth. So we can either decide to go for a couple of 4-stars or just 2 5-stars. So predominantly, this team will be made up of 3-star players. Hopefully, this team will be able to contend for a national championship. This first season will be a mixture of FCS opponents and D1 opponents. And we'll hope to kick some ass, so to speak, and get ourselves to a national championship. Without any further ado, I think it's time y'all met the team. The first player on our team to talk about is the one, the only, Baldwin Lutherkirche. Lutherkirche is actually from Germany. He never really had much interest in football until he saw highlights of the greatest show on turf on YouTube. After his family moved to the United States, he tried out football in his junior year of high school, was a pretty darn good quarterback. However, because of his late start to the game, he ended up not getting much offers, save from some FCS schools and from UNC-Pembroke, where he committed. Lutherkirche has been the starter for the Braves the past 2 seasons. He's provided being quite a capable starter with a good arm. However, his speed and mobility in the pocket leaves a lot to be desired. He will be, as you can see on the screen, a 68 overall. Our second option at quarterback will be Derek Knox, the backup from Spartanburg, who has been a running back most of his football career. However, he went to be a quarterback in his final years of high school. Quarterbacking was not bad at all for Knox. However, a UCL tear in his junior year required that he get Tommy John surgery. The throw power he is still trying to get back. Only one school kept their offer on the table for him, seeing his mobility in the pocket. As you can see on the screen, he's got good accuracy. However, the throw power is still a work in progress. Then comes the player I hope we don't see on the football field. Don't remember. If you ask him what his name is, he simply just doesn't remember. Don't remember. All he remembers is that he was a quarterback. His memory was damaged in a lab explosion while studying here at UNC Pembroke. We're hoping that he'll be able to find some of that knowledge soon. He's not very mobile at 40 overall. However, we are hoping that he'll become a solid football player in time. Not sure what he'll develop into as the time goes on. Hopefully we'll find out more about just who he is. Moving on to the running backs, this is a player from the actual UNC Pembroke roster, Jaquan Kelly. Kelly's got some average speed and agility and acceleration, so we're hoping he'll be a good contributor. He had a nice broken tackle right there. We're hoping he'll be pretty darn good. At the running back slot is Spencer Faulkner. Utility player on the Braves baseball team, known for leading the team in stolen base percentage, he joined the football team to help out once the team got to D1. He's got good speed and acceleration, though not very agile. He'll definitely be a good option for us at the running back role. Next up is the speed option in Dave Bautista. Before he was the wrestler we know today, Dave Bautista had a stop at UNC-Pembroke to play running back. As our fast running back, we'll hope he can definitely make some plays, getting that good blocking from his lineman. And we have the old man on the team, Divine Wilson. Divine is 33 years old and working on his graduate degree, a former pro baseball player, made up as high as double A. Divine is old enough to possibly be some of the player's dads. However, Divine looks to see if he could at least show what he could do at the college football level for his 1 year of eligibility. He's not that fast, but he does have the strength and is willing to be a leader for the young men in the running back core. Moving on to receivers, we got some pretty darn good receivers, including the best player on the roster, Grant DuBose. Grant, of course, a remnant of the Charlotte team. We kept around due to him transferring to UNC Pembroke. We're hoping that he'll be a great leader at the receiver position for the years to come. On the other side is Luis DePaula. Luis, a 6'160" warrant receiver out of Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic, was an Ironman athlete in high school as a cornerback and a receiver, setting his high scorecard for receiving touchdowns and interceptions. However, in his senior year, a Lisfranc fracture on the first snap of the first game of his senior year ended any hopes of major college offer. So he is stuck at UNC Pembroke. We'll see if he develops something pretty darn good. The slot, we'll have Theo the Fox McLeod. Look at that movement, boys. Theo ran a 4.29 at a track meet in Idaho Falls, Idaho. Out of Walla Walla, Washington is Theo. He's got good speed, good acceleration, but the catch in traffic is a struggle for Theo. We're hoping he can use some of that speed to help get past the corners in year number one. That's right here, ladies and gentlemen. On the other side is Javion Smalls, another player from the actual UNCP roster. Moving on to tight end, we have Keegan Sweet Feet McGinnis. This man's 6'6", 246 out of Manassas, Virginia. Keegan has talent. He's a setup man on the Braves baseball team. He looks to be a pretty darn good tight end. He's our second best player on the team behind Grant DuBose. And he looks to him to be a solid target for Luther Kirsch, definitely a favorite for the German QB. Back up for McGinnis is Will Swain. From a Navy family, he looked like he was going to be in the Navy until he got kicked out of his high school JROTC class and focused on football. He was expected to be McGinnis' backup for the time being, and we'll look to see if he can develop into a Mackey Award winner. Nothing much to talk about on the O-line, but how about the big center, Austin McDougal? He's been a capable center for the Braves the past couple years at D2. However, McDougal's over-aggressiveness, getting the laundry bag of flags, has made him a big risk for the Braves. We're hoping we'll be able to tune down that aggressiveness and make him into a better center. Another guy on the O-line to talk about is Mr. Thickus Garum, the brother of another player on the team, Skinny Rushum. Thickus is a big man from Athens, Georgia. He's got great strength and his size makes him an imposing offensive tackle. We'll see how he performs. We also have MB Nagy from New York. MB's got a little undersized for the position, but we'll see what MB can do. Only allowed one sack his senior year, but as you can see, size does matter, and his undersized stature might be a bit of a risk, but he's the offensive captain due to his longevity and a bit of a prima donna status. Well, hopefully that doesn't go to his head like it did Antonio Brown. Moving on to the defense. Ghislaine DeWeart is your runner. You can see that great rush right there. He got past Thickus Garum. So Ghislaine DeWeart from Massachusetts looks to be our best defensive player, or our best guy on the D-line for sure. Assisting him will be Las Vegas, Nevada's Ryback Reeves. You better feed him more sacks. Looks like he's about to get a little lick on Luther Kirsch then. No, Luther Kirsch will get it away, but he looks to be a talented right end. This right here is Constantine Thornbuckle from California. Constantine has not had much stability in his life. His family, of course, being airman in the United States Air Force. He's moved around all across the country until it's finally settled into Kinston, North Carolina. However, this did give him much time to make a school choice, so he chose UNC-Pembroke. This is the first bit of stability he's had. Thornbuckle's a downhill-type player who will look to seek out the quarterback and get those TFLs. However, his tackling leaves a lot to be desired, so the coaches will have their work cut out for him working on that form. This right here, folks, is Balls Gaming. Balls Gaming comes to UNCP by way of Raven. This is a story that was come up to him by a member of my chat, Legend of the Fallen, who is the guy who came up with Don't Remember. So it's a crazy-ass backstory, but I guess Balls Gaming was a crypto scammer who invested in Balls Coin and made it a big thing in Saudi Arabia, a pump-and-dump scheme. And to escape, he assumed the identity of a football player. Let's hope he can stay on the field, though, and not end up in jail. At linebacker, we have the very talented freshman Caden Swinford from Wilmington, North Carolina. Swinford was expected to help out the family fishing business. However, being 6'7" really means you got a knack for sports. Swinford's really good on the hit sticks, but his coverage leaves a lot to be desired. We'll look for Swinford to really be able to get to the QB in his first season as the middle linebacker. Assisting him, Solveta Stockwe and Adler Storen, the distant cousin of MLB pitcher Drew Storen. Adler's from Cincy, Ohio, didn't get much offers because most of his games got rained out. He's got good talent, though. The Pembroke scouts think he'll be quite a talented player. Into our main cornerbacks, this is KJ Capps, and on the other side is Mr. KJ Rivas. The cornerback position looks to be one that we're lacking on, so that'll be the first thing that we have to address in recruiting. We're hoping that Capps will be a talented player, as will Rivas. The safeties, I think, are the best part of our team on defense. How about the freshman Jay Smith? 6 months ago, folks, Jay was not even human. Jay was a bird that was captured by 12th grade student Bucky Jeremiah Smith. For a science experiment, Bucky tied himself to Jay, a bird he caught in a Buffalo Wild Wings parking lot, and turned into a 6'6", 200 human being that Bucky named Jay. Jay later took up football, trying to find something to do now that he's a human, and was pretty darn good at it, leading his team to the state championship. However, they lost to Hialeah Gardens High School, occupied by KJ Rivas. He walked on the UNC Pembroke to be closer to his brother, who committed to the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill. Jay Smith looks to be a really darn good player. Can see him back here in coverage. Hopefully he'll get better as the year goes on. And all the way back here, you have Dontavious Jackson. Oh, Dontavious is a specimen I'm very excited about. Look for Dontavious and Jay Smith to really guard the deep of the end zone. Handling the kicking duties for UNCP, Valeris Ostroskis of Lithuania. Valeris was a soccer player who was attending King Charles University in the Czech Republic. However, Valeris went to the United States as part of an exchange program, loved the U.S. so much, he decided to transfer and ended up being on the football team as the soccer team was full. He's got good kick accuracy, but we need to work on that kick power. Our puncher is Kimmy Weddle. Weddle's always had the leg, because we all remember that one kid that was so, so good at kickball. Weddle has quite a powerful leg, was good in rugby, soccer, and football. The problem is, though, he could not kick the ball straight. He had the worst qualified field goal percentage of players in his home state. And because of that, he was not giving any offers to be a kicker, so he has become the punter for the Braves. Right now, we'll rely on Ostroskis to get the points, but for the power, we will look for Kimmy Weddle. So there's the team. We kind of suck, and it's gonna be possibly a rough go, but you never know how things might end up looking for the Braves. A little bit about this series. The games will be played live on Twitch, so go to my Twitch channel, twitch.tv/MattyJonesFM, and you'll be able to see these games done live. And they'll be edited up and posted on YouTube, so go check the channel out. That's where you can see the games live. You will also be able to get a player of your own through recruiting. We'll try and split it up between Twitch and YouTube, but for the most part, this should be a pretty fun series for sure. As for the schedule, we'll be scheduling games against four FCS teams. So this first year will be weird as an independent before we will make a full jump to D1 play as a member of the American Conference. This will be our transition year. First game, FCS East. Game number two will be the game that we get a lot of money. We'll take on Clemson in Death Valley. After that, we'll go on a bye and take on those Michigan Wolverines in the Big House. Then we'll end the three-game road swing against the Navy. After that, it'll be two straight home games against FCS teams. Then a home game against the Maryland Terrapins, our first big matchup at home against a Power 5 opponent. Then it's off to Akron, Ohio to take on the Zips, then FCS Southeast. Then we head down to Memphis to take on the Tigers. A home game against Air Force, and then our final match, which we might get absolutely destroyed, we'll take on them Dawgs as Georgia will be our final opponent of the season. Why don't we then jump into our first game against FCS East? Kelvin Sampson, the former Houston basketball coach, returns to his alma mater not to coach basketball, but to coach football. UNCP's first season in D1 is underway. Agbaugh will take this kick, and we are ready to go. Gehen! Lutherkirche, Valerian Agbaugh, and is again the basketball coach, Kelvin Sampson. Ladies and gentlemen, the first play as a D1 school in UNCP history, Bodewin Lutherkirche, the German QB, takes the snap from center. He's looking. He's going to look for... Oh, no, it's a pick! That's not good! He was looking for Keegan McGinnis, but the pass was way off target. Zeke, what's up, bro? Swinford! Oh! Swinford took out Trey Ball's kneecaps! And Caden Swinford, the young freshman from Wilmington, gets the sack! Oh, what a play! What a sack, dude! Don Docio! Oh, Thornbuckle! Oh, Farmer! That's Javin Farmer on the tackle there. It's the 3rd and 12. Dontavius, there you see him right there. Manny, du wadama idiot, hilf mir Dyson, a got for damen, wazer werfen, du plesga phantom simp! What, he just called me a simp? Oh god. What the hell, Lutherkirche? Oh, how about Swinford making a nice tackle once again on Trey Ball? Swinford might be pretty darn good, man. Oh? That's capped in the tackle there, be 3rd and 5. But a Stockwee, he's not that fast. Fuck! Oh, it's picked off! It's picked off by Smith! That's Jay Smith! Jay Smith! All right, Lutherkirche, let's see if this shit works, okay? Oh, Lutherkirche, slow as fuck, but he'll get the 6-yard gain. Let's go. Come on, Kelly, Jaquan. Good gain, Jaquan. 3rd and 1. To Kelly again, and Kelly will pick up the first UNC-Pembroke first down. Oh, is that Keegan McGinnis? Oh, what a dart! What a dart! Let's go, Catskin! And Keegan McGinnis, a 23-yard pass there. 23-14. Nice. Look at this throw, guys. Look at this throw. A little bit wobbly from Lutherkirche, but oh, right to the big man. Sweet feet, Keegan McGinnis. And you can see Keegan's pumped up. Kelly gets blasted, though. Yes. Oh, I should have used her there. Oh, what the hell was that? Lutherkirche. Storin. Jay Smith, good tackle. Oh, Rivas slows him down to Johnson. That's Dontavius Johnson with the tackle there. Not a bad tackle at all by Dontavius. Well, they broken play. Did we art? No, the quarterback will slide down. Be a first and 10 for FCS East. Oh, I messed up. Agbaugh! Fuck! Ooh! Rivas, what a hit! Mel Bundy. Swinford. Providing some pressure. Screen. Oh! Oh, fumble! Jay Smith has it! He forces his own fumble, and he picks it right up! Oh, my God! Jay Smith! Utrakirche to Jaquan Kelly. It'll be a nice game. I never talked. Oh! Luther Kirsche scrambling! Luther Kirsche! Oh, I tried scrambling. Fuck. Alright. Kimmy Weddle from downtown. Just short. Oh, Farmer! Oh, good pressure by Farmer. Dontavius with the play. Bench Luther Kirsche. Oh my god, already. Caden Swinford and Jay Smith are like the beasts of this team, man. They got Smith. Oh! He laid into him again. This time the running back holds onto it. Oh! Good coverage. Ooh, Dontavius Johnson! Ball's gonna scramble. Oh, that's a big... Oh, no, I dove too soon. Rivas! Good tackle, Rivas. Ball's gaming in on the play. Ooh, Caps and Johnson with the TFL there. I think so. Swinford with the hit pressure. Oh, good tackle. That's a fourth down. All right. Oh, they're gonna go for it here, guys. Oh, shit. All right, fourth and two. Fuck, they got the touchdown. Shit! Let's see if Luther Kirsche is fully settled down. I hope he's settled down enough, you know? Will Swain makes this catch. Oh, good throw. Good catch. Maybe we shouldn't have done it there. Oh, God. Luther Kirsche. Oh, my God! What the fuck, Luther Kirsche? Oh, guys. Thank you. Oh, what a hit. Oh, Dontavius! No, why did it pause? Get back to me, game! Dontavius! Dontavius! Let's go, Dontavius! He is him! A little too late for that. I'm just gonna keep Luther Kirsche in, you know? Yes, Keegan! Good! Oh, Keegan! What a spin move by Keegan! I think we should. Here's Kelly again, and Kelly will get nothing. To Kelly. Oh, what a move by Kelly. We love seeing that. Jaquan Kelly. A good run there by Jaquan. It'll be second and two. Oh, sorry, third and two, rather. Oh, you do? I actually mascotted a game against Furman. Fun place to be, man. I like that area. Kelly, let's go. First down. Skinny rush him. Skinny rush him. Let's go. 8 yards. Oh, that's the Grant Dubose, the UNC Charlotte transfer. Oh, Will Swain was a little bit too off far. Too off far for that one. Oh, shit! Look at Luther Kirsche! First down! Luther Kirsche! What a run! Luther Kirsche! He's gonna scramble! Look at the end zone! Keegan! Touchdown, Braves! Keegan Sweet Feet McGinnis scores the first D1 touchdown for UNCP! How did he get the foot in bounds? They're gonna review it though. Oh shit. Please tell me it was in bounds. That right foot's down. He's dragging it. That right foot's there in the end zone, but they might overturn it. Please don't. Yes! Oh, Dontavius, the pressure. Ryback getting there. Good tackle, boys. Great way to keep Trey Ball contained. Swinford with some pressure on ball. He's under some heat. He's going to scramble right back, chasing after him. Uh-oh. Caps. You've been great today. That was awesome. That was solid. Good tackle. Damn it. We are not looking good. Shit. Look it up, man. Give me 1 second. Oh, John Dontavious! Dontavious! Ball caps got beat! Duh! Just wait till the Braves start. When the Braves start, like, getting winning records, all right? You won't be able to find a seat in this stadium. Come on, McLeod! I fucking. Mmm! A7, that's correct. Luther Kirsche. Gonna throw it. That's the Grant DeBose. What a catch. McGinnis. Great. I'm gonna call timeout here. He's gonna scramble with Luther Kirsche. Throwing the run to Theo, and Theo makes the catch. First down, Braves. Theo McLeod, we gotta hurry it up. Clock is not on our side. How about Theo McLeod with his first catch? Deep ball. It might be picked off. And it will. I tried to get too. I got too greedy. End the half, and it looks like the Braves need some work. 14-7. I mean, we still have a shot in this game. We still got a shot, man. Well, let's. Let's look back at this game, though, man. Not the best debut so far for Luther Kirsche. One touchdown, two picks, 9 for 17, 117 yards. Not a good day on the run game, though. We gotta get some work going on the run game. Keegan McGinnis, how about sweet feet? 460 yards, one touchdown. You know, I like it. And how about the two picks? Dontavious Johnson. Jay Smith, the sack by Thornbuckle and Swinford. So, I mean, we ain't looking that bad. Good tackle, Jay. Oh, come on. Oh, Swinford got shoved to the side. Good job, boys. We need help here, boys. Swinford! Let's go, Caden Swinford with his second sack. And the Braves will force FCS to punt. Swinford bowls over the QB's knees. Let's go. And we only get 2 yards. Great. Oh, Skinny rush him. Let's go, Skinny rush him. 16-yard gain. Y'all want the hard knocks life for us. Here you go. Knox. Oh, let's go, Knox. Good run by Derek. Same play. They won't fall for it again, will they? Oh, let's go. We still got 5 yards out of that. Let's go. Luther Kirsche. Get back in here, man. To rush him again. And, oh, rush him shoves a man on the side. We'll get the first down for UNC-Pembroke. Four verts. Luther Kirsche trying to run away. He'll somehow get 3 yards. All right, I'm gonna put Keegan on a streak. Oh no, I see B. That's DuBose. Let's go. Here we go. Luther Kirsche. He almost got the first. I would have dove, but I didn't want to do it. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Luther Kirsche! What a run. To Dave Bautista! Oh, he got decked! Dave got decked! Alright, Knox back in. No, that didn't work. Fuck. We'll get the Wildcat. Too late for that! Dave! Fuck! And we got nothing! So I'm going to kick the field goal. I'm going to get points here. Ostroskis kick is good. Smith, good tackle. Oh, come on, Jay. Oh, God. Oh, what a hit by Johnson. Boom. Oh, Swinford again. He just tied the school record for sacks in a game. Thornbuckle gets free, hits the QB, pass complete. Smith brings down Thompson, and that means the FCS team has to punt. Here's Dave Bautista. Oh, good one by Dave, man. Dude, people watching the YouTube are going to be like, what is that Soren kid typing? They're going to watch this video when I do it on YouTube. Like, what's the Soren kid typing? Really, though? How will it? I don't know how it'll affect LeBron's legacy. That's a great question, though. Big throw, DePaula! Oh, Luis DePaula. Gotta catch that, Luis. Oh, block? Oh, here goes Knox! Oh, big spin! Derek! Come on, Derek! Let's go! We might have a QB big controversy on our hands now. Knox or Luther Kirsche? We might just have one on our hands, folks. Oh, to Smalls! Oh, what a dot to Javion Smalls! First and goal, UNCP, as we go to the fourth quarter. UNCP down by four. The team is playing fantastically. Can the Braves come back to win it? To Dave Bautista. Dave! Can't get in there. All right, second and goal. McLeod makes the... Oh, he couldn't bring it in on the out route. It'll be third and goal. DePaula! Oh, he's just short. Take the points. I want the lead! Riley Ken Wright! Swinford! Oh, big hit Smith with the TFL. Yo, Jay Smith is him, dude. Jay Smith is him. Winford and Smith might carry this team. They might carry this team, man. Pitch. Swinford. Oh, no. Smith. Big hit. Oh, big hit. Smith. Oh, he got shoved to the ground. Oh, no. That's not good. Dontavious. Oh. Oh, Agba. Agba! Good job, Dontavious. Go staying in zone. Oh, come on. Ivanov. Oh! Alexander Ivanov, former KGB agent, makes the QB flip. Oh, my Lord! Run play. Swinford should have this like, oh no, the block. Oh no, 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 Johnson. Yeah, when one of, like, the thing with this team is when one of our guys gets like stiff arm like that, dude, they're going to get a huge gain. It makes me scared for the Clemson game. Now that I think about it, this makes me scared for the Clemson game. I am absolutely terrified about the Clemson game now. Oh, right back. Feed him more. He's going to probably cover the running back now. I've blitzed him in. All right, run play. Oh, I messed the hit. Good tackle. Come on. Oh, let's go. Jay Smith on the coverage. And now it'll be fourth and goal. They're going to go for the field goal, boys. I'm going to go into a safe zone. I never trust the computer on these situations on my slides. I'm going to go into a safe zone. And the kick is good. Bautista. Dave Bautista. He breaks free. There goes Dave. Oh, that's a huge play. Come on, Bautista. We'll see. McGinnis. Keegan. McGinnis. Sweet feet. Sweet feet. Keegan. Sweet feet. McGinnis with the big gain. Hey, can't wait to play tomorrow, dude. It's going to be fun, man. Here's Dave on the run. Let's go. 5-yard gain for Dave. Serve clock. I want to go for the dub, man. Luther Kirsche. Oh, come on, Knox! Oh, Spencer Knox! Big first down for UNCP.
Say my name.
He's gonna look. Quick slant. DePaula! Luis DePaula makes it first and goal for the Braves. To Dave. Spin move. Oh, he's just a yard short. Valeris Ostroskis. This is only the second field goal he has ever attempted in his career. He is a junior from Lithuania. To get UNC-Pembroke their first win in D1. It should be a chip shot, but you never know. It's a college kicker and good! With 1 second to spare. Squib kick it. Come on. It's going to bounce. Picked up by Lacey. There it is! Game! The Braves have won! It was not pretty at first. Victory.